from passing that ball.
Running each other. Were you much of a run?
Absolutely not, Jeff. I stood on the line of scrimmage and my victims, I mean, rival players, came to me. Come on, guys, together!
This is going to be decisive!
Haha, here's some friends. Attacker has an assist.
Oh, that's a shot! Now, can they capitalize on this? This player likes to be well assisted in a fight.
Huh.
fight.
They're getting up close and personal, Bob.
You need to be close. So close they can smell your breath and see the dead insects in your teeth.
You know, I may actually say something witty and insightful soon. I'm just waiting for the players and the coach to do something. Anything! Please, just be interesting. That player was about to get punched above and below the belt at the same time.
Gathering around that bold player, like halflings round a sandwich.
Unity is strength. That's a strike made with... Second, what's happening down there? More pain for that team. Their pain is our gain.
Hey.
Failure that could cost his team dear. That's a bad pop. Not helped by the rain, of course.
Player's taking the ball, and the end zone is close.
A good solid handle. These two players work well together. That's a touchdown! I'm so excited my heart really started. An extremely fast first touchdown. The other team must wake up.
They're down a player. Easy to replace.
They kick the ball to the opponents. Now it's time to think defensively.
Jim, did you know that some cheerleaders get paid more than the players?
Is that a fact, Bob? Why?
Well, it's a question of what the fans are looking at. Who would you rather? Is this gonna be enough to come out on top? Casualty so early in the match? Hey, I might actually start paying attention.
Good. He's got the ball. It's always embarrassing when they fumble that bit.
The attacker has an assist.
That's a dangerous place to be. Hey!
Is this going to be enough to come out on top? With Blitz flailing, he's following up, hoping to get the knockdown next time.
Can you hear me now, though? Okay. Yeah, I figured out what was the problem. Okay. So, what I'm gonna do? This one's gonna come here. No. Here. All right, that's good. Yeah, to let you know how the 1-0 happened, I wasn't able to pick up the ball in my first turn because I decided to not reroll my block rolls. Then he moved three players in my side, so I had to do a passing. But in the pickup roll, I used one of my rerolls, and see. And what happened there next was that the catcher lost, couldn't catch the ball because he's an idiot, and he managed to give the ball to his catcher and score there. So yeah, not the best start. That's why now we're desperately looking for some injuries. Good. And I will stay like this. Two more turns. No. That's absolutely fantastic. And another stat down. This is one of the unluckiest starts that I have seen for high elves. So anyone who wanted to see a few deaths in injuries for elves, we don't have for the wood elves, but high elves are doing their job properly. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring this fella here. No. It's a difficult decision. Get this one to stand up, just in case. All right, I'll do slightly risky. It's hope he's not gonna fail me another time. All right, good. And now the blitz is gonna be here. That's good. I wouldn't mind another injury. Ah, okay, 3, 6, 7. The war dancer is gonna come here. This player is gonna come here. This war dancer is gonna come here. Yeah, yeah, that gives us a clear opportunity here now to score without huge problems from the high elven team. I hope he might have still a few tricks in his sleeve. And this one's gonna come here. I'm not gonna even bother with him. And right, let's hope nothing crazy is gonna happen. No, 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 no. The right guys are getting injured. Although I'm a big fan of high elves, I consider them my best team. Okay, I don't mind them getting injured today. And the injuries, yeah. Oh, the cats are running here. Good. All right, and the last blitz, just before we score. Not great, but what can you do? And our player here, member Forbidden Stars, is gonna score his first touchdown. Remember Forbidden Stars? Would like him to stay there. Okay, so now I'm gonna. Just put the team back here. So the next 7 blocks, these 3 and the four in the second half. Gonna show us a clearer picture what kind of game we're gonna have in the second half. At the moment, it's a huge riot. I had the riot in last game, and that's why I lost. If anyone wants to see the video, it's one of the funniest things. If the game stays as it is, second half is going to be very interesting because he's going to have the clear advantage of having the ball and the offense, but we are going to have +2 players. Even if it is +1, it's going to still be a big thing for Wood Elves. Yeah, this is something that I really need as an event, but not the best thing when it's the end of the half. No. Yes. No, I'm not gonna risk it because we have some expensive players to keep safe. Sorry. No. Okay, we are going to the second half with +1. Not the best, not the worst. You see that? That's what my catcher has to learn, because last 2 games my catcher is killing me. Go on, guys. Okay. Okay. Yeah, let's go this way. possibly he's going to use the catcher as a ball carrier. That's going to make him a powerful, fast option. Yes, yes, that's good. That's absolutely good. On the other hand, this means that he's not going to have the option to give the ball to a fast player to get to go very far away from my defense. This extra roll is massive. Now we even might see some leaps, if you are good guys. All right. Yeah, he's going, oh. I thought he was going for the block in the wrestler. For the blitz. Yeah, possibly it's gonna do with this one. That's good, that's very good. And now we just hope that the rain is gonna play its part, and it doesn't. Fucking rain, always raining everything. Okay. Good. Stay. Yes. All right. So we still are plus one player. Now it's time to get dangerous. A chance. Try to put some pressure with the catcher there. Do the blitz. Although this is not the best way to play with elves, I will try here to force him to spend some rerolls, either by blocking me, dodging, putting players against mine. Because now, skill-wise, we do have the advantage. I have four skilled players against two plus one the catcher, but basically only his speed counts now. And this one is gonna come here. And the block. Good. Come on, another injury. Ah. Okay. Let's see what these high elves, what tricks they have. The good thing is that everything can be contained now, even if he finds an opening. I have the speed to to be able to play the proper defense. And also we are able to put some pressure to the catcher. Oh. Yeah. Even if it is KO, this means that for the rest of this drive, we're gonna be with equal amount of players. And I never liked this. So he made the proper cage here. And he's gonna get an opportunity to do a block. Thankfully not successful. This stinks. And out of nowhere, we're minus one player. That's not great at all. Three, four, five, six. Yeah. All right, we all know why you all came here today. You actually want to see war dancers doing a few leaps, and possibly this is gonna be the outcome of the next turn, this turn. So I will try to I will bring this player just in case. That's good. This Loner is gonna do his things, stuff here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. So, is anyone ready for leap? Come on, do it. Fuck my life. All right. So now possibly the whole game goes towards the high elven side. No worries. Nothing is done for good. So first leap in the whole tournament and went as I was expecting it to go. The good thing is that at least the armor did break. And I don't think he's gonna risk foul, but there is an option. If he injures his... Fucking hell. Yeah, you can celebrate that you have a good elf dead, but thankfully it is the loner. So, no big deal. The biggest problem at the moment is not this, is that we are now ourselves minus two players. In just three turns, the whole game has turned around. He's gonna try to create a cage now. Let's hope that's not gonna be successful. And it isn't. That's good. Those two war dancers have had far too many successful hits on them so far. So this bloods has to start working at some point. I mean, it's 70% when someone doesn't have a tackle for them to defend properly. So come on. All right, and this is clearly an indication that we need to have another leap. Yeah, Crowdog said that the player was a loner, it was his destiny to die, and this is actually the destiny of loners and star players. 9 out of 10 times that I'm buying a star player, I wanna have so much cash, they end up dying. Okay. Are we gonna go the extra risky way? The thing is, if I do not risk it now, there is a good possibility that I'm not gonna have another option to risk it. So risk it for a biscuit. The biscuit is a lie. Alright, this player here, this player here, this player here. And now member Rebellion has to repent himself. Finally, and that's good. Where is the ball gonna go? Left, left, left. Ah, not great, not terrible. And you know what? I will try to get the ball. The odds are 33%, yeah. And he did it. All right, that's good. Now, where should I move the player? This player. Conduits there. This one, conduits. Yeah, fuck it, I'll just put him as far as possible. I know that he's gonna blitz me, but at least he's gonna be far to his field, and I have the ward dancer here in case even that the catcher is gonna get injured, to try and do this, the ward dancing stuff. Alright, that's good. Every time that there is a failed block in this ward dancer means that another player is becoming useless for the defense of the ball. Just gonna try to defend the front. Possibly is he this one? Yeah. If he does a GFI, possibly he might be thinking that he's gonna do a three die. Yeah, he's thinking to go for a three die block glitch. And now it's 40% to get him down. Yes. You gonna use a roll? No. So yeah, I'm gonna. You know what? Let's be brave. Yes. The reason I did this, although, yeah, I do realize that it was risky, is the fact that I wanted him to end the turn now, to not have the opportunity to do any more blocks here. And it worked well. Also, it was 7 against 7 in the armor values. So not a huge disadvantage. Three, seven. Okay. Everything is gonna have its risk now. I will stand up the catcher. Okay. Let's hope that we're not gonna see snake eyes now. Good. Good. Yeah, I'm not gonna do anything else risky apart from trying to get the ball. That's good. But where to go with the player now? Alright, now we can do a few more risky moves. Understandable. All right, so possibly, yeah, I'm not gonna say anything because you never know. Everything can have anything can happen here. The problem is we now have left with only one reroll. No, don't kill him. Good. This is an actual reason for celebration every time a block to the word dancer succeeds. Okay. And I hope that this is not gonna be successful here. Don't do it. Fucking hell. At least stay alive? No. At least he's still in the game. Now, where the ball is... Oh. I hit my life. Oh, everything worked well there for the high elves. Fucking hell. All right. At least no injury. Should I do? This was a really bad outcome. I'm not gonna try to get the ball this turn. I cannot afford to spend another reroll if things go south. I'll just try to bring this word dancer, a good one, closer to the ball. And for the rest, we'll see what happens. Okay, not a terrible turn for our side. Three more turns for its team. Only one reroll for the wood elves, and we probably will have to use it. I'm not sure though if he's going to be able to do a proper cage, so we might even have the ability to blitz without need to do any leaping. Oh. Wanderer, we always root for the wood elves. They're the best. Well, as I said, my favorite team is High Elves. I've been playing them. This is the team that I am going most of the time. Because of their resilience, but the Wood Elves, on the other hand, the thing that is fascinating is the speed, the opportunity to go anywhere, anytime you want. Right, let's see. Is there gonna be any opening to this player? To Jessup. Blitzer comes there. I need him to spend the reroll. This dot has to fail. Ah, come on. Right, he's gonna try to go there. It is a difficult position for the High Elves. It's a difficult position for me too, though. He's gonna have the opportunity. Oh, that's good. Another failure. Damn it. Only my damn catcher loses the ball all the time. Okay, so now he has the advantage that he has the ball on the bleacher. That's not good. We desperately need the failure here. I hate this Alvin shit. All right. Your damage, there is a chance. Right, what I will do now that we also have the Blitzer here, I'll do something a little bit risky. Instead of leaping, I will use this Word Dancer to just dodge here, because with the dodge it's 75%, so there's no option for me to spend the reroll. Good? Yes. Yes. Not there. Up, 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 up. All right. That's actually good. Try to bring the catcher. Please do it, do it. You cannot fail me another time. Okay. And no, I'm gonna leave this on there. I'm gonna try to pick up the ball. No. Okay, not the worst thing that would have happened. Alright, the good thing is that we didn't spend the reroll. Two more turns. We have three players that can potentially score. And of course I'm gonna bring more in the next turn. And I don't think only this catcher can go away here, but he has to get the ball. That's not very easy at the moment. Yeah, the rain is ruining the game and my nerves. Ah. And the armor rolls in the second half, someone could say. But yeah, the first half was on my side, so I cannot complain too much. Let's see what's gonna do. If he goes to Blitz a catcher, then it's gonna be a little bit problematic for myself. Even if he just pushes him. Ah. This is only 30% and happens 2 out of 3 times. And still hasn't used the reroll. In this, oh, he did. Oh, sorry. So he has. He doesn't have a reroll for this. Nice. Is he gonna block the word dancer? Or the possibly the other player? Oh. It's 30% that it happens, has happened 3 out of 4 times. And the best word dancer is out for the rest of the game. That's great. Oh yeah, here, I didn't see the double skull, sorry, yeah. Oh, yeah, sometimes because I have to switch views, I miss a few things. Damn it. And we're gonna have three players for this drive. Oh, fucking hell. The way that I see it, we have to play for the win, no matter what. So I'll try this. Try to blitz the blitzer, push him to the ball and hope for something good. Up. Up? Ah. That's not good. That's not good at all. Not even going to risk this. Yeah, I don't believe there was much more that I could do. So yeah, we're going to the last turn. Both teams have one reroll. Good game indeed. I assume that he definitely is going to get the opportunity to get the ball. I just hope that he will have to use a reroll or that he will miss a throw, something. Come on, it's raining, you have to... Yeah, I believe that I'm gonna lose this game too, to be perfectly honest. Please rain, please money too. If this is successful, I think he wins. It is. Fuck me. Yes! Yes! Ah! Finally, a catcher that did the same thing as mine. And what should I do now? That's a lifesaver. At least, even if we possibly, yeah, I'm gonna get the 1 point, but even 1 point is good. No. Yeah, just gonna do the blitz here. This self can get the ball. Fucking hell. Yeah, and now let's go for the crazy stuff that never succeeds. Yeah. All right, that was it, guys. Tough game. On the one side, Crowdog was able to score a really fast touchdown. On the other hand, we managed to get the superior numbers in the field. Second half, this changed. We managed to control the game as much as we could. He overturned the situation in the field, having plus four, plus five players. I think plus five it was in the end. But he had this double, this snake eyes roll that totally destroyed his chances to win. I'm not sure. I think draw was a fair result. ourselves, we had also some unlucky rolls, but the major thing is now we're talking about a Wood Elven team that has more skills, that has a third reroll. So this is going to change our way of playing from the next game. Now, let's see what's going to be. Let's give another wrestle. It's free. Okay, so yeah, now the team is getting as much wrestle as possible. Another game with no major injuries. So far we have only one player. Possibly, I'm not sure again yet, but possibly I'm going to fire this player that had the minus one strength. Next game, yeah, is going to be a bit tricky. Is, I think, against the Goblins. It's against Goblins. It's a game that main thing is to try to not have to survive first and foremost, but we definitely have to win because now we are only with 4 points. Here is the leaderboard. We are 3 points behind the second place. That gives a possibility, an opportunity for the playoffs, and 5 points behind the first place. That's not good enough, so I have to do better. Thank you all for watching this game. Thank you all for watching also the first game. I apologize for the sound not being great in the first game. I figured out what the problem was, and it's not going to happen again. Other that, don't forget to follow. Don't forget to follow us also in YouTube. Subscribe, ring bell buttons, post, do some screenshots. Everything, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. I don't have them, but you can share all the information. Other than that, enjoy your evening, have a nice day, and see you next time.